So we are standing in the Quest airlock, which is divided into two parts. We have the equipment lock and we have the crew lock. This equipment lock has a hatch right here that closes, and the crew lock has another hatch. The EMU, or the Extravehicular Mobility Unit, is our spacesuit, and it's divided roughly into two parts. We have the hard upper torso, which is almost like a turtle shell. It's a hard fiberglass shell. And then we also have the lower torso assembly. These spacesuits are our own little spacecraft, and they have everything you need to keep you alive out in space for 7 to 8 hours, maybe even longer, depending on how hard you're working. The only thing that they do not have, and they have radios, it has oxygen, it has carbon dioxide scrubbing, it has temperature control, it has everything you need, except for one thing, a restroom. And so when we get ready for our EVA, the first thing we put on in the morning, is a diaper, and that's our first layer. Then over the diaper, we put on a pair of long johns, and that's to keep our arms and legs from getting scraped up. It also provides a little bit of wicking in case you're getting really hot and sweaty. The next layer is our liquid cooling garment. And the LCVG has little tubes running through it, which allow water to circulate with inside the LCVG to provide cooling when we're outside working really hard. So we've got the diaper, we've got long johns, we got the LCVG, and then we're gonna wear our spacesuit. 7 layers from the bladder on the inside, which maintains pressure, and that's a rubberized bladder, all the way out to the white layer on the outside. The crew member inside the spacesuit is also wearing this, what we call a Snoopy cap. It's a communications cap. We have a radio, so we can talk to not only to Houston, but we can talk to people on the space station and to each other. So we wear this communication cap inside the helmet. Also, another key component of the EMU, or a spacesuit, is the helmet. You can see the helmet has a gold visor, which protects us from the rays of the sun that we can bring down. It's pretty bright out there, and this gold visor helps reflect the rays of the sun so we can actually see and operate in daylight. At nighttime, we can raise this visor up, gives us a clearer view, and additionally, we have helmet lights built into the helmet. On top of the helmet, we also have a television camera, so the ground is able to watch us while we work through these TV cameras. The work is really all done with hands, and so our gloves are really our most important piece of equipment in order for us to work outside. And one of the real challenges of a spacewalk is you have this heavy gloved hand, which is inflated. So it wants to stay like it's blown up like a balloon. But we walk by grabbing onto handrails and making our way along the ISS. So every time you move your hand, you're fighting against a balloon that wants to inflate. And then on top of that, all of our equipment is based on using your hands too. So after 6.5, 7 hours of kind of fighting against this glove, it's a really long day, and your hands are probably the thing that are most exhausted after 7 hours out on an EVA. Well, we're going out to work. You probably saw me move this mini workstation. The way we carry our tools is on a mini workstation, which is carried on the front. Every single tool we use is tethered to us. We do not want to accidentally create satellites. Our primary way of remaining attached to the ISS, if we're not using our hands, are these waist tethers. And you can see they just have a big hook. They go around a rail or anything else on the ISS and latch on, and it actually has a locking mechanism as well to hold us nice and tight. So we always want to have one of these attached if we're not holding on with our hands as well. The back of the EMU has our life support system. The life support system contains all the equipment we need, from a UHF radio down to the oxygen tanks that provide primary oxygen. One of the challenges inside this sealed environment, it's very easy to carry our own oxygen with us, but we generate a lot of carbon dioxide, particularly when we're out there working very hard. So to combat that, to deal with that, we have these canisters called Medox canisters, which are just silver oxide. They are carried in the backpack along with a very large battery, which provides all the electricity for us. I don't have a battery here to show you today because we're in the process of charging them. We're about a month out from doing a spacewalk, and we've already started getting ready for that. So this Medox canister is able to remove about 7 to 8 hours of carbon dioxide that a human can generate inside the spacesuit. EVAs have allowed us to build and maintain the ISS, repair mission-critical hardware, investigate malfunctions, install new hardware, and the view, unbelievable. See you next time.
Subscribe for more space.